Hello, PreK friends. It was so nice seeing you all on Zoom yesterday. I hope those of you who did not get to join us that you got to see the recording that we did. We had a lot of fun. All right, so today we're going to talk about more about the water cycle. We got a lot of things planned for today. We're going to make a water cycle in a bag. We're going to draw on our bag. But first, let's go ahead and let's get started with our prayer. What I want to do is for you to think of who you would like to pray for today. Who is your intention for? So for today, my intention is for all of those who are still having to go to work every day. I know some of your parents are still having to go to work every day. And I want to pray for those who are working in our pharmacies, are working retail, in our hospitals, who are taking care of family members. These are all very important jobs. And I know a lot of you are missing your moms and dads because they're having to work. So let's pray for them today. And my friends, Babe Ruth and Derek Jeter, they decided they wanted to share the responsibility of holding the flag. So I told them that I would go ahead and do the prayer. So I thought we would go ahead and do apples are big. So can you do it with me? In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Apples are big. Grapes are small. Thank you, God, for making them all. Amen. And a special prayer for all of our friends out there and for all of our family members who are still having to work and all of our intentions. Amen. All right, I'm going to move the camera. We're going to get started with our pledge. So let me move it over to Derek and Babe here. All right, and you guys can stand up. And I'm just going to kind of stand back here. Got a little bit too far away. So put your hands over your heart. I'm going to put your hands over your heart, and we're going to say, I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right. Thank you, Babe. Thank you, Derek Jeter. All right. So now let's go ahead and let's get our wiggles out. Move my chair a little bit, and we're going to do the oats and beans and barley song again. All right, so let me get that started. So get ready for oats and beans and barley.
Oats and beans and barley grow.
Oats and beans and barley grow, oats and beans and barley grow. You or I or anyone know how oats and beans and barley grow.
Remember your seeds.
First the farmer plants the seeds, stands up tall and takes his ease, stamps his feet and claps his hands and turns around to view his land.
Oats and beans and barley grow, oats and beans and barley grow. You or I or anyone know how oats and beans and barley grow.
Then the farmer watches the ground, watches the sunshine all around, stamps his feet and claps his hands and turns around to view his land.
Oats and beans and barley grow, oats and beans and barley grow. You or I or anyone know how oats and beans and barley grow.
Much better that time than we have before. Here I go, forgetting to shut the songs off again. All right, here, okay. So let's talk a little bit about what we are going to do today. So for today, I want you to go on YouTube, and there is a book called Mud Pie Annie, and it's actually a really funny book about a little girl who makes mud pies. So that link will be in the email for mom and dad. And also for today, for your art, there's a video out there. I uploaded, there's another video. It's actually two videos, but it's going to be on one link. And it is for you to make a water cycle in a bag. Now, I've already completed it. This is what it's going to look like when you're done. First, you are going to draw everything on it. And then we're gonna talk about filling it with the water, and this is what it's gonna look like when you're done. So you're gonna make one of these today. That's gonna be your science and your art for today. The other thing I want you to do is I want you to look at measuring cups, because that's part of what we're using today with our art and our science. So you have measuring cups. I happen to have 4 different size measuring cups here with me today. Boom, boom, boom. Here they are. All right. So which one is the biggest? The red, the green, the yellow, or the blue? Ooh. Did you say the red? You were correct. So now, which one of these is the smallest? It's kind of hard to hold all of them. Which one of these is the smallest? That's not quite so easy, is it? Did you say the green one? You are correct. It is the green one. Now, that leaves 2. They're kind of like medium size. They're not the biggest, they're not the smallest. So we're going to do a comparison. So I'm going to hold 3 measuring cups up, and we're going to talk about which is the biggest, which is the medium, and which is the small. So big, medium, and small. So here we go. We have the yellow, we have the blue, and we have the green. Now this one should be very easy for you to do because we just talked about it. So which one is the biggest? Did you say the yellow one? If you said the yellow one, you are correct. So which one is the medium then? The blue, very good. And then the green is the smallest. Okay, ready for this one? We have the red, the blue, and the yellow. The red, the blue, and the yellow. Which one is the medium? Medium, I mean it's not the biggest and it's not the smallest. Did you say the yellow? If you said the yellow, you are correct. What about which one is the smallest? Did you say the blue? You were right, it is the blue. So what's that make the red one? That makes it the biggest. Very good. So you guys might have some measuring cups at home that you can do that with. I happen to have one that has 4 measuring cups in it. Your mom or dad might have one that has a lot more. I've got one inside that has like 8 measuring cups or something, but this one only had 4. So look at the measuring cups and or other things around the house. There might be other things that you might see. Go pick up 3 different rocks. Which is the biggest? Which is big? Which is medium? Which is small? And do a comparison and see which one is bigger. Let's see. The other thing that you can do today is if you can pretend like you're swimming. I want you to lay on the floor on your belly, and then I want you to lift your head up off the floor, lift your feet up, put your arms straight out in front of you like you're going to swim, and then I want you to bring your arms up and down while you're kicking your feet. And the only thing that should be touching the floor is your tummy, and I want to see how many times you think you can do that, okay? That's going to be really hard. It's going to be hard on the stomach, but I know you guys can do it. I emailed your moms and dads a list of letters on Monday. You should be choosing 2 letters a day and practicing your letters. And then don't forget to also include practice writing your name. All right. Today is going to be a great day. I hope you have a lot of fun doing your water cycle. If you guys have any questions, let me know. And I hope we get to do a Zoom meeting real soon. Bye.